It was always hot in my grandparents' house. And I don't mean I should have worn short sleeves home. No, it was more like it's August in Ethiopia hot. Growing up, I remember sitting in the living room, sweating, trying to figure out my relation to these people, who not only didn't share my same environmental needs, but who had also reached an age I could barely comprehend. My grandparents firmly believed in the three acts of life: family, faith, and food. So every Sunday for 29 years, I rode a bus from the city. And I went sharing with them for dinner.
The very day I turned 14, my father put me in a boat. In my pocket, he stuffed 200 lira and the address of a cousin in a place called Hoboken, New Jersey. The only advice my father gave me, tango familia. If you just said that in English, it would be, I support a family. But in Italian, it means more, much more. I am a man, I'm doing well for my woman and my children. I have a reason for being alive.
Tango familia.
I arrived to learn my cousin had moved to a faraway land called Brooklyn. So for 6 weeks, I lived underneath a pier off the Hudson River, every minute of every day, trying to figure out a way to earn enough money to get back home.
I was the middle sister of seven girls, and Frank was the first man. Oh, the first person to ever know this. He was making a dollar a day as a carpenter's apprentice, and I thought that was a fortune. He promised that if I married him, he'd do for me, an entire house. And he did. He became a wonderful carpenter and built for me this beautiful home.
My grandmother, Ada, never made it through grammar school. Never even learned how to drive a car. But locked her in a kitchen with tomatoes, pots and dough, and garlic, and she was dying some. By my 29th birthday, my parents had moved to Florida, and my sister, Melissa, to San Diego. Before she left, Melissa told me the best thing about being American is if you stay in the country and still move 2,000 miles away from your family. I stayed at my grandparents. And every Sunday, I bore the heat and relentlessly showed up for dinner. But one Thursday, something happened to me. Something important. What I had to tell them couldn't wait. Hey, Grandpa. No, ma'am. I just ate, and I can't stay long. Like I said on the phone, I just have to make this announcement.
Yeah, it's no time to do me any favors, Ada.
What did you have for dinner?
Chinese food.
Chinese?
Ma'am.
You call that food?
Well, everyone eating it seems to think so.
30 years ago, I had dinner at a Chinese restaurant, and to this day, I have no idea what I ate.
Ma'am, I'm full.
Fine, I'll make you a sandwich.
Ma'am.
You look hungry.
How? Tell me exactly how do I look hungry?
You're breaking my
heart. All right. A small sandwich.
What do you want on it?
I don't care.
How about provolone?
Perfect.
Nicholas, I'll make you a provolone and ham sandwich. You tell your grandfather he can't. can't drive no more.
What?
Don't listen to her, Nick.
2 days ago, he ran into the parking lot. He needs to put the car in reverse and goes forward.
I thought it was reverse. I put it in second.
Right into a Jesse's car. Thank God no one was killed.
Barely dented the fender.
2 weeks ago, at 7-Eleven, he needs to step on the brake pedal. He steps on the gas pedal.
We go very fast for about 2 feet.
Right into a Japanese car. Thank God no one was killed.
All right. Prince, you know you shouldn't be driving anymore.
You're telling me what to do? I need to change your diaper.
Graham, you told me. I appreciate it.
He never changed your diaper.
Graham, this is just too dangerous to be behind the wheel.
I get in the car with him. I scream the entire way.
She's a real pleasure to drive with.
All right. Nan, you go make the sandwich and I'll talk to him. Could you please open a window in here? It's sweltering.
That's crazy. It's only June.
But it's hot.
Air conditioner doesn't go on until the 4th of July.
Fine. I'll open a window. You listen to your grandson.
Graham, you know something terrible happened.
I have to drive your grandmother to the store.
She can walk. Take the bus.
I only go close by, that's all.
And you still get into accident.
What are you saying? I'm too old to drive?
Just your reflexes. I will help.
I'm out of trouble, Ellen. You want cheddar or mustard?
Whatever, Ann.
I want to make it the way you like it.
How can you make it the way I like it? I don't even want it.
Don't? Fresh. Cheddar or mustard?
Cheddar.
Are you sure?
Absolutely. 100%. I want cheddar.
But I got such nice mustard.
Oh.
This is the woman you're listening to, so I can't drive?
Oh, my.
Mustard. I want mustard.
I thought so.
Look, I just don't want to get a phone call saying you hurt yourself, or Dan, or someone else.
My first car, 1941 Soto, cost $53 more than I could possibly spend. Once I laid eyes on it, chrome wheels, black leather inside, dashboard that was the most beautiful sight I ever saw. I worked 3 months night, shoveling coal to some restaurant furnace so I could get that 53. And when I bought that car, when I actually sat behind the dashboard, when I held that perfect new steering wheel in my hand, that's when I knew I could make a life for my family. If I could own this car, I could make a life. Thank you, Amelia.
Thank you.
Got another set hidden in my tool.
Oh, you promised me only drive an emergency. All right?
Yeah.
I was the first person in my family to get a good job with the union. It was for a Ford automobile factory. And the way I got the job was easy. I told them I was Irish. I had to, because in those days, the only famous Italians in America were the Pope and Sacco and Vanzetti.
Did they look at us and think the Pope? No, Sacco and Vanzetti.
My father spoke Nuncio and Emma, was just 2 doors down. And every Sunday, they'd also visit and share dinner. Both children of hard-working and destitute immigrants. They married at 17 and had 2 sons. My dad and his brother Nick, who was killed in Greece.
The day I married you, my mother sat me down and told me something amazing. She said, Emma, just because you're his wife doesn't mean you're not important. Speak up. Say how you feel. Don't become one of those women who get lost behind their family. Huh.
So I told Ford my name was Ian Sean O'Brien O'Malley O'Sullivan, and I got the job.
So while Milt went to work, I made us a beautiful life at home.
I stood on the assembly line, putting this nut and that bolt for 27 years to give my wife and son the life they deserve.
We struggled and made our way because we're a family. Tango Familia.
Tango Familia.
Tango Familia.
They were the loudest people I ever met.
Yoo-hoo!
Hiya, Nicky!
Hi, Jeff. Hi, Nicky.
What a pleasure to see you on a Thursday.
I'm glad you came. I have something to tell you.
Well, wait, Nick. I want to take a picture.
Grams, I have this announcement.
It's one picture.
Grams.
One picture. Go stand over there by your grandmother and smile.
Grams.
Your hair nice first.
Yes. All right, Gramps. Shoot.
But you don't look happy.
I'm not.
Why the hell would I take a picture if you don't look happy? Okay, I got one more.
Make a copy, dude. I'll pay you for it.
No, enough with the picture. Sam, can you get back in here, please?
Oh, Nicky. That present you bought for us, the one we don't know how to use.
The answering machine?
No, the other one, the CPU.
Oh, the DVD.
Right, you need the receipt.
Why, is it broke?
No, we just hate it.
Oh, we don't hate it. It's just too expensive. We don't know how to use it.
Why are you worried about the expense? I bought it for you.
Oh, just give us the receipt. We'll give you back the money.
I don't want the money.
It's too much to spend on us for a BCP.
But it's for your 60th anniversary present.
Fine. We'll keep $10.
Look, can we talk more about this later?
What I have to say is, Nicky, guess where your grandmother wants to drag me again next Tuesday?
I'm sorry if I like to go places. I'm a doer.
Atlantic City with the senior citizens from St. Anne.
Look, Grams, what I have to say is something...
You know what I did last time we were there? I walked into Donald Trump's, and I took the $30 in tips that the church gave us, cashed them in, found a $5 buffet, ate all day, and I came home with a $25 profit.
Look, I have to...
I told him that money was not for him to keep. Catholic Church gave him that money to gamble. Sunday, you put it in the poor box.
I am not putting it in the poor box. We're poor. I'm giving it to Nicky.
We are not poor.
Why are you giving me $25?
I don't know. She won't let me
keep it. I'm glad you said cheddar and Munster. So I sit on both.
How can I come from these people? My parents, maybe I should understand. But these people?
Nicholas ate Chinese food tonight.
That's like eating cancer.
He also told me I can't drive no more.
Good. The world just got safer.
Oh. I'll give you the receipt for the DVD. We'll talk more about the driving later, and I'll eat the sandwich. Can we just everyone sit now, please?
Are you going to sit?
I'd like to say what I have to say now.
Before you start, who's hungry?
What you got?
I got a new crumb cake.
The kind with the big crumbs?
From the A&T.
I'm in.
I'll just have a sliver, but a healthy sliver.
I want a big
one. Don't announce anything yet, Nicholas.
Hey, I'm just not getting here.
Nicky, before I forget, I got you a math card.
A math card? Are those for sick people?
10:30, two Thursdays from now, St. Anne's Mass will be set for you.
Why?
Well, in hope she'll meet a girl to marry.
And the priest agreed with it?
Hey, go to the mass. Maybe you'll meet her there.
Whatever you do, don't talk to Father Vincenzo.
Not with Father Vincenzo again.
Hey, 15 years ago, him and I had a big falling out.
About what?
I don't remember. I just know I was right.
Okay. Here we are.
Thank God.
Can we move on, please?
Wait. I feel his wrath.
Me too. What's open?
It's 110 degrees in here.
We're old. We're chilly.
Oh, my. I forgot all about it.
You know, it's a good thing you got that man. You almost put a little air speaker in the room. Does everyone have a coffee? You almost want coffee? Does anyone to survey the unavailable draft?
Okay, all done. Make me a copy of you, so I'll pay you for
it. Can I please see this now?
What's he getting so upset about?
Mickey was always a nervous baby. Remember how he used to chew on his rattle?
Can we not talk about the rattle story right now?
We're just trying to better understand you, Mickey.
Oh, and the rattle story just explains it all. I don't even know why I bother going to therapy.
What?
Enough of that therapy.
He said he's going to therapy.
What the hell's that?
He's going to a psychiatrist.
Foot doctor?
Head doctor.
What?
Nicholas, you're seeing a head doctor?
Oh, my God.
Look, it's no big deal. All my friends are in therapy. It's just someone to talk to.
What kind of friends do you have, Mickey?
Look, I said it was no big deal.
Can't you just talk to us?
How? I can't even get this announcement out.
Do you pay this person, or is it covered with insurance?
I really don't want to talk about this right now.
I hope you don't pay this person.
We listen to your problems for free, Nicholas. Priest would too, Nicky. Should I call a priest?
Always calling a priest.
Shut up. Talk to my grandson.
The other day, my back hurts. I hear her on the phone with the parents.
Nicholas, tell us your problems right now.
I come out of the bathroom. Father Fanelli is standing there waiting to bless my spine.
Can I please say this now?
Go ahead and say your announcement, Nicholas. We're all with you.
Okay. Let me start with you.
All right.
Everyone quiet.
Okay.
Okay.
All right.
Okay.
We're ready.
Okay.
All right.
Say it loud.
Okay.
Okay.
All right.
Okay! Now, what I have to say is, I got out for the promotion.
Congratulations!
Wonderful, Nicholas.
What kind of promotion? Well, it's a management position.
Well, tell.
Well, I would, but I don't think you quite understand what it is I can do now.
Well, just because we don't understand doesn't mean we don't want to hear about it.
Okay. Well, as I explained before, I'm in marketing. Which is kind of like advertising, you know, commercials, and, well, I actually don't make the commercials. I plan overall strategy for commercials, you know, like newspaper ads and various other types of media, such as billboards, brochures, and internal and external sales presentations. Well, and what the new job is, well, this is exciting. I'll be in charge of developing and implementing and coordinating all these strategies, well, in a top 20 market.
Well, whatever the hell it is you do, we're damn proud.
Good job.
Good job.
There we
go. Well, the thing about the job is I have to move.
Oh, out of the city? Oh, thank God. Nicholas, you can move in with us.
No rent,
No, the job is against the island.
Where the hell's the island?
Well, the Noah has a beach house there, exit 94 on the parkway.
No, her house is further down, by the big food town. No, no. Wait. I know where the island is. Washington. And not the close Washington either. The far away Washington. The one by California. All the way by California.
Nick, is this true?
It's in Washington State. Yeah. Look, I just got the offer this morning. My head is still swimming. Well, now would be the right time, right? I'm unattached. I've got nowhere else to go, and well, I don't have anything to keep me here.
What about us?
Yeah, it's up to you.
Nick. So you're leaving.
Moving. Yeah.
Right. Leaving.
Look, I've talked to my parents, and they make it a wonderful opportunity. Besides, I've grown up here, and, well, I've never lived anywhere else. Well,
I've never lived anywhere else.
Well, I know this might be a bit of a shock.
A shock? Why should this be a shock? First, your parents moved to Fort Lauderdale, then your sister gets married, moves to San Diego, and has my great-grandson.
Grand.
I have one great-grandson. And he's 3 years old, and I've seen him exactly twice. Why?
Grim, please.
You know what that's like? I've lived long enough to have a great grandson, and he doesn't know who I am, why I'm important to him. Last time we got off the plane, and he saw me standing there with my arms outstretched, and he ran away. He thought I was just another old person. Another old person who wanted to annoy him with a hug.
Nicholas, I don't know, Frank. You mean you're just gonna go?
Look, I just wanted to tell you first. I'm sorry, I... It's getting late. And I've got to catch the next bus.
Can't be.
I've got a 9 a.m. meeting about the promotion.
We'll see you Sunday, Nicholas. If we're still alive, God willing.
Well, we'll talk more about it then. It's a wonderful opportunity.
Yeah.
He forgot his sandwich.
20-minute ride into the city. He'll make it without food. Seattle.
Not to worry, he won't go.
You heard him. He said he wants to move away.
No, he didn't say he wanted to move. He said he had no reason to stay.
So?
So? We'll give him a reason.
Bella, I should tell him that the doctors have done their test. I should tell him that if he takes this job when he says goodbye, it'll probably be the last time we see him. But I should tell him. Then maybe he'd stay.
Well, most companies have an unwritten rule that if you say no to a promotion, another one might not come along.
That day, my boss had sat me down and said,
"This opportunity means that we have great faith in you. This means that we're planning something even bigger."
And as any young man can tell you, the lure of a new job is seductive and alarming. That following Sunday, I returned for our weekly visit, at which I thought they'd be laying the guilt on something fierce. But they didn't. They did something worse. Hello?
Hey, Nick.
Hi, Gramps.
So how are you feeling?
Good.
When do you put them in the lab?
Oh, when I was a little boy, my father called.
Your grandmother found them in a garage sale the other day. The last night I took the class, they were having them in the high school.
The high school? How did you do that? You didn't drive.
I walked. 45 minutes. In the dark. There and back. I dropped dead. I left specific instructions to deliver me to your doorstep.
Hi, Nicky.
Hi, Jim. So, what's a jacket and tie?
What, we can't dress up to see our grandson?
So, about Seattle, I guess you both have had time to
get over it. You want Nicky?
Nothing. So, how are you doing?
We're good, Nick. How can
you? No, about the promotion.
Oh, we're very, very proud.
Nicholas!
Nan, about Seattle.
You're a little hungry. Why don't you call me Sarah, little
Mike? Hi, Nan! Look, what is going on with you people?
Who is this? You people. We're not people. We're your family.
Look, 3 days ago I told you about my promotion, and now it's like I never even...
Nicky, how old are you?
What? 29.
29 and no family. You know that 8 years older than your Uncle Nicky ever was.
What? What brought that up?
Just been thinking about it lately.
Why?
Nicky!
What, man?
I combed
it in the afro, man! Look, what's going on here? Something's going on.
I'll get it. What's the reason? Why, it's Caitlin O'Hare, the unmarried niece of my gymnastics partner, Margaret O'Hare.
Oh, my God. Not too late to escape.
Come on, Nick. You know, we'll tell them the last.
Or Caitlin, even in my most generous moment, I wouldn't call these people relaxing.
Yes, very pretty, isn't she, indeed?
Yes.
I did good. Caitlin, you look fine. Huh?
Good. Oh, God. Oh, God. Oh, God.
Nicholas, why don't you give this back to Caitlin? Very nice. Very nice.
Shall we just eat now, quickly?
Oh, shall we say grace?
Since when do we say grace?
Shut up. We have to sing. Frank, say grace.
Really? All right. Get ready, everybody. I'm going to say grace. All right?
Everyone quiet.
Okay.
Okay.
All right.
Okay.
We're ready.
Okay.
All right.
Say it loud.
Hey, grace.
All right. Bless us, O Lord, for these thy gifts we're about to receive. And bless our lovely dinner guests and our lonely grandson. And may they find eternal happiness together.
Amen.
Prayer. What? It's a prayer. I can say whatever the hell I want.
So, Caitlin, I'd like to see Nikki married before I'm dead.
If not, I have to go with her.
So, Caitlin, I bet you like to drink.
How do you mean?
Well, you're Irish.
Great.
What? The Irish like to drink. That's a secret?
Great. Apologize now.
Actually, I'm not having a party now and then.
See, life is to be lived. You know, Caitlin, the Irish used to hate the Italians.
Okay. Change the subject.
So tell me, Caitlin, do you drive?
Ramp.
Well, sure, don't you?
It's funny you should ask.
He hasn't stopped. He's beginning to act.
I've killed hundreds of people.
Caitlin, I made some lovely meals. Here, Caitlin. No, thank you, Ada. I'll just have some vegetables. Oh, but it's nice. It's from
ShopRite.
No, thank you, Ada, anyway. But I'm a vegetarian.
She's a what?
Vegetarian.
What the hell's that?
Animal doctor.
She fixes animals so she won't eat them. That makes sense.
No. Vegetarian. That means that I don't eat. And my
daughter's
a nurse.
She's an animal nurse? What do animals need nurses for?
Chuck, don't try to correct them. Chuck, just write it out.
Well, whatever it is you do, it sounds very nice. How do you feel? No,
not at all. No,
I'm sorry. I
should have pulled that out of the closet. Oh, no need
to apologize. Just have some veal. Man! The veal issue is closed.
She doesn't eat veal.
But it's nice from the
ShopRite. Man.
The squash is beautiful from my garden.
It looks fabulous.
You could serve it to the Pope.
The Pope would eat the veal, too.
So tell me, Caitlin, what's an attractive girl like you doing without a boyfriend?
Caitlin, please don't answer.
It's okay,
Nick.
Well, Frank, I'd like to say this. Just that I haven't met the right guy lately. Well, maybe if you did something with your hair.
I get that.
Dinner.
We'll go to the next vegetarian restaurant, and no one will ask if you're in therapy.
Well, I have to like one therapy.
Oh, well, I don't, but I like you. And let me just say, I'm really, really normal away from my family. I'm actually intelligent, somewhat charming, and sensitive.
In a very macho sort of way.
So, is it wrong for me then?
Maybe.
Oh, maybe. Maybe it's not bad. It's not bad at all. You know, my grandmother's right. She's a good.
And if I have a confession to make.
Uh-oh. What? You've got a boyfriend. You've got a girlfriend. What? You really a man?
Nick, I knew you'd be here tonight. That's actually the real reason why I came. Well, it's just that I've been feeling a little lonesome lately. Well, maybe even a little desperate. Oh, God, I said it out loud. But now I'm a little desperate, and, well, I thought, I swore your grandmother, and I thought maybe she had a grandson who, well.
Interesting. Well, if I may be so bold, what do you think of my grandson?
Well, that's the thing. Well, being a good night with the grandparents, well, it's only reminding me of my mom.
Oh, right. You think they were all gone.
Yeah, well, I didn't know my mom's mom, but that's not it. What I'm trying to say is they spend the whole evening yelling at this.
Oh, yeah. Well, we're family, and that's just the way we speak, you know. I think you and your grandmother just speak so.
No, no, we never yell. We just talk.
Oh. Maybe I should try that.
Actually, my grandmother used to speak to me. After my grandfather passed away, as a way to get through the day without him, she'd read to me. Books. These wonderful books. But not too many children's stories. Oh no. She would read some songs. These wonderful stories. When I was about 9 years old, she read to me Great Expectations.
What? She read you Dickens? In its entirety?
Well, it took 6 months. But, you know how grown ups try to read children and put them to sleep? Not my grandmother. Oh no. She was reaching me such tight. And I just hold on to her so tight. The voice was covered like blankets.
So, Caitlin, how about it? Let me take you out to dinner tomorrow night. Well, please?
Well, that's the thing. Seeing you here. When I was 13, my grandmother, no, I'm sorry, I don't speak that word.
A what?
Get upset. I'll get a food bowl.
No. No food now. Everyone sit. under the knee.
See anyone standing?
Did any of you take into consideration how I would feel? Did any of you take into consideration how your sneaky little plan, which didn't work, by the way, was infringing upon my life? Hell no. And what was that plan? What did you expect? For us to fall in love and meet and spend the rest of our lives together?
Yeah.
Well, it doesn't happen that way.
It happened to us.
That was 150 years ago. Today, we do things different. We have careers and ambitions. And we choose who we fall in love with and we pick. And we're damn good and ready.
Well, that's the problem right there.
You know what? You guys did what you just wanted to. You wanted me to live my life your way. Well, you know what? Maybe I don't want to get married.
That's crazy.
I'm talking. Maybe I like my life the way I've made it. Maybe I need to find out what I'm about.
What?
You know, now I know why Melissa and my parents really moved. Because they wanted to live away from constant interference and judgment and criticism. You know, I was feeling guilty about going to Seattle, thinking maybe I shouldn't because I've been leaving you. Well, you know what? Now no guilt. I'm home free. I'm out of here.
Nicky!
You know what? In 1 month, I'm going to get on that plane and fly away. Fly away to a new life. And I'm going to do what I want. And I'm going to date the women I want. Not relatives of my nanny to NASA partner. And I'm going to go to therapy if I want. And I'm going to eat Chinese food if I want. Hell, I might even go to therapy and eat Chinese food there. Well, you know what? And this will be new to you all. But I'm a grown adult. Yes, there's a fully functioning grown-up man standing before you who's fully taking care of him.
Nicholas!
Can't breathe.
Got a heart attack. Call an ambulance. No, we can get him to the emergency room faster.
Nicholas! Nicholas!
Emma, get the front door. Ada, get the car door. Noose, help me carry him. I'll drive. So I drove my grandson to the hospital. And I didn't hit anybody or anything. And this was under great strain and stress because I thought my grandson was having a heart attack. And as it turns out, he did have an attack. A panic attack, they called it. The doctor said he had to stay in bed and rest for a few days. So we figured the best thing to do was to have him stay here with us.
You know that song, Over the River and Through the Woods, to grandmother's house to go? It's such a happy song. Those people are going to see their grandparents. They're singing and dancing.
Nicholas, what else can I get you?
Man, you've been feeding me nonstop for 2 days now. Could you please open the window? It's hot in here.
I don't want you to feel a drag.
Man, it's hot. I'm expecting Batman and towels to walk by.
I'll get you a dinner blanket. The other nanny and grandpa are coming over for dessert later, and before they get here, Nicholas, Seattle, you really might not go, right?
What?
Well, I was thinking, if you were so sure you wanted to go, you wouldn't have gotten so upset, so you did.
Oh, God, man, I'm so sorry.
Nicholas, all I'm saying is maybe you're absolutely 100% sure that you want to go, but at the same time, maybe you're absolutely 100% not sure at all.
Okay. I'm going to have to hear that one more time.
Nicholas, remember the other day when you were yelling that your parents liked you and didn't want to be around us anymore?
Oh, God, man, I'm so sorry.
Nicholas, they didn't leave because they didn't want to be around us anymore. They saw themselves getting old. They saw their lives being spent in one place. They got afraid of becoming too much like us.
No, Nan, that's not right. They just want to live in sunshine.
Nicholas, people don't move away from their families because of the weather. No, they got afraid.
No.
And maybe you are too.
No, 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 that's not right.
Calm, Nicholas, calm. Breathe. Okay, maybe I'm just all wrong, okay? Maybe I'm just all wrong. But I'm not. You, Nikki?
Hiya, Nikki, you're looking good.
Nikki, how you feeling?
Oh, I'm fine, fine.
You gave us such a fright, flouncing like that.
Oh, I'm so sorry, Nan.
So I got you another math card. It's down at 30, St. Anne's, open from Tuesday. Mass will be set to you.
They're gonna have to name this church after me, so.
Don't do that to us again. We're old. We're supposed to get sick, not you.
Nicholas was getting too hot.
It's perfect in here.
Well, look, I said some things yesterday about wanting to move and not wanting you to interfere.
Oh, maybe you were sick then.
No one listened to a word you said.
Besides, I got the perfect way for you to relax. Come with us on a vacation. We'll pay.
Oh, I don't know, Nan.
Next month, we're taking another one of those Mario Perillo tours.
Again with the Perillo tours.
Why? You had such a wonderful time last year.
But you're always going somewhere. You get on the bus, you get off the bus, take a picture, get on the bus, off the bus, take a picture, on the bus, off the bus, take a picture. It's exhausting.
Nan, I'm going to be in Seattle, Nan.
Maybe he'll meet a nice girl on the tour.
On a gorilla tour. All the girls are 80 years old.
Mario Perillo is Mr. Italy.
Somehow I don't think this trip is gone to relax.
Nick, you stay here and rest a few weeks, nice and quiet. Then you think about the trip and Seattle some more.
So what should we do tonight?
Oh, just nothing that gets Nikki too excited.
I know. Let's play that game you got us we don't understand. What's it called?
Oh, Trivial Pursuit.
That's it. You have to answer things.
Do you feel up to playing a game like that, Nikki?
No, he'll drop dead from all the excitement.
Look, I'm fine. You want to play?
Oh, let's play.
Guess who I saw at Cathcart this morning? Caitlin O'Hare.
Terrific! The last time you invited her here, you nearly killed the boy.
Oh, she's still very nice, Nikki. And her aunt is such a wonderful canasta player.
Oh, yeah. That's exactly what I look for in a woman. Look, can we just please play?
Whatever you want, Nicholas.
How about you and me, Jim?
Okay, Nick. You roll the dice, play the game for us. We'll just come up with the answer.
Wait for just a minute. Hang on.
Okay, blue or yellow?
Oh, hang on. Hold the cards up. So are we blue or yellow? Hang on a minute. Okay, you're on green.
All right, green.
Everyone quiet.
Okay.
Okay.
All right.
Okay.
Ready.
Okay.
All right.
Bring the question, Grant.
All right. Green question. All right. What's the process by which plants form carbohydrates? when they're exposed to light.
What the hell kind of question is that?
That's what it says.
Too hard, give us another.
Who started with it?
Wait! That's the whole point. If you can't answer the question, you lose your turn.
Well, what the hell kind of question was that?
It was a science question.
It was about a plant.
Look, it's the first question. They're not thinking hard yet. We'll give them another just for now.
Oh, that's right. I forgot the whole not thinking hard yet question.
Oh, here's a nice one. Who starred with Lana Turner in High Noon?
That actor.
Yeah, the guy with the ears.
Yeah, I always liked him.
That's right. Go again.
Wait! That's the answer on the card? The one with the ears?
No, but I know who they mean.
But they have to tell you who they mean. That's the game. That's why it's fun.
Now, what was her name? Irma. Remember, we were both surprised to see you with this guy. And she wasn't drunk, and he had no teeth.
Yeah?
Well, what was the guy's name?
Something.
Yes, it was a Jewish name. What's a Jewish name?
Ada, who do we know that's Jewish?
I think Henny Young is Jewish.
You know Henny Young is?
No. No, but it's something like that, but different. Who else?
Sissy.
No.
Matt Burrell.
No.
Jenny Green.
Ma'am, you know the answer.
Got caught up in the excitement.
Is Merv Griffin Jewish?
Merv, wait, that's close. Irving. That's the guy that was with Irma Irving.
So the ambassador, Washington Irving.
That's right.
You know, that's really tough.
Nicky, you're laughing.
Yeah.
You've been so worried lately. I don't remember the last time I saw you laugh.
Oh, come on.
She's right, Nick.
Wonderful, Nick.
When we were your age, we were always having fun. We didn't have much of anything, but we were always having fun. You take things too hard.
Yeah, well, leave the boy alone.
No. We've all been quiet saying nothing, because we don't want to give him another attack. But I'm his nanny, and I got something to tell him.
Gonna give him another attack.
Nicky, you expect too much. You go looking for the perfect girl so you find no one. You spend so much time worrying about so much. Your job, where you're gonna live. You just expect too much.
Let's be your grandmother, Nick.
That's right. Because we never expected like you expected, Nicky. We were told a good life is when you find a husband, have kids, food on the table, you don't die doing it. That's a good life. Then we went ahead and told our kids they could have so much more. They could go to any school they want, meet wonderful people, and maybe that's the way it should be. And you already have so much more than we ever had. And we're so proud. But then you gotta go to a head, and the whole family moves away. And we never had. So is it a better life? It's not a worse life, but better. Just different. See, he didn't have a cat.
Enough with the game. Who's still hungry?
I can use the Danish.
No, wait, I want to tell a story.
Okay, just let me get the Danish.
No, this story is so good you don't even need food.
There's no such thing.
What story are you talking?
Story of how I was you.
Oh, stop. No one wants to hear that old story. No. Oh, they've all heard it.
Well, he always changes it.
How about you, Nick? Do you want to hear it?
Long as it doesn't get me too excited.
Okay. Well, Nicky, your grandmother used to live in a fourth floor walk-up, not far from here. And every night I'd sneak over the fence. Go into the backyard and I'd serenade her.
This is not true.
Would you let me tell my story?
Story is right. His father dragged him to my house. My father talked to him. His father talked to me. Then both fathers told us we were getting married.
It happened 60 years ago. Can't I tell it the way I like it? Okay, Nicky, the first time I saw her, she was standing on the street corner. It was a beautiful day, beautiful sunshine, and she was waiting for a bus.
I was the most gorgeous, eligible, popular girl in the entire neighborhood.
What?
You're telling the story the way you want. I'm telling the story the way I want.
Okay. Well, Nicky, when I first laid my eyes on your bed, well, there was something about her. She was smiling, and I was so amazed because I'd never seen anything so beautiful. She was so beautiful, you could bring her from a glass.
I was wrong. Every word of this is true.
Naturally, I couldn't speak words to her, so I just stood there and watched her get on the bus.
waited right there until another bus returned her to that spot. Then as she strolled home, I followed her, which was right underneath her window. I did this every night for a month. Every night for a month, I sang her this one song. Yes, sir. That's my baby.
Wait! I'll get my man.
Don't mean baby. Yes, sir. That's my baby now. When she finally did come down, I was still too nervous to speak. So I just kept on singing. Yes, sir. That's my baby. No, sir. I don't mean baby. Yes, sir. That's my baby now.
Whenever I see an old black and white movie, I can't help but think that's what it was like in my grandparents' day. That they lived these very black and white lives. They were very serious, very earnest, rather joyless. But sometimes, not often, but sometimes, I get a glimpse of what it was like in their day. And suddenly their lives are splashed with color. And I get a peek of them when they were young and sexual. Their lives are all laid out before me.
Nicholas, I need a partner.
Yes, sir. That's my baby. No, sir. I don't mean baby. Yes, sir. That's my baby now.
Who's hungry?
How about you and me going home?
Nicky, would you mind if we leave you early?
No.
Nicky.
Go.
This is the reason I want to see you married, Nicky. This is the reason.
Frank, Ada, see you tomorrow.
Not long after, I learned that my father got tangled in a fishing net and was being thrown into the water. And his head hit the side of the boat and they never found it. 8 years to the day that my father sent me away, I returned to my hometown so my mother and my sisters could meet my new family. It was during the holidays, and on Christmas morning, I took your mother in my arms, and carried her outside. And there they all were, all the vendors, like they had never left, with all their beautiful blue and red toys. And anyone your mother would point to, I bought for her. When we came back in, our arms full with this rainbow of toys, my mother took one look at me and said, "That's what your father wished he could do. But we barely had enough to buy food at Christmas. That's why he had to send you away. You can make for yourself a life you can never do." I always thought my father was a bastard. He would never give me anything. Turns out, he was giving me all he had. You're going away, aren't you, Nick?
There's a moment when I wake up each morning and I don't remember that I'm sick. It only lasts for a few seconds, but it's like a little gift I get at the start of each day. That night I told my Emma. The first time I cried about it was when she began to cry. I made her promise not to tell anyone. That's for me to do. It would be so selfish of me to tell him. So selfish. But when you get to be my age, you realize what matters is family. What matters is family. And what's in Seattle? Just some job.
I don't know what it was.
Maybe it was the way the light was hitting her in the face, the way she was standing. Or maybe it was that a woman who rejected me had come back to apologize. I don't know. I just know at that instant, she seemed like a perfect woman, so intelligent, like the beautiful woman on the planet. And I wanted her to like me so much. But for a second there, I had a horrible thought. Could my grandmother actually be right? Could all I ever need to be happy is the right woman? Oh, God.
Lorna said that
he
might go to Seattle soon, that
he
has to turn a job
offer. Oh, right. A promotion.
Hey, do you know anyone there?
No. Just a promotion.
Well, Nick.
Yeah.
Well, I'm glad you're okay, Nick. I gotta get going on my shift in a half hour, and I can't be late. You know, there are some animals that need nursing.
What was it? I know you already should know, but, well, how about it? You and me?
That in the movie? Seattle?
Right. Well, I thought about not moving. Staying here.
Well, Nick, what happens if we go out and decide that we really like each other?
Well, I don't know, Mom.
Well, I don't know, Nick. They got me tonight, but I can sit there all night thinking that I wouldn't like to do it. It is a good idea, Nick. I'm sorry.
Yes, sir. That's my baby. No, sir. I don't mean maybe. Yes, sir, that's my baby now.
Wow. Alright. Nick, decide not to go to Seattle. Okay, you call me, and it's safe. No relatives. No talk about therapy. You're on. But Nick, decide to go, and go. Start over.
Connected somehow, and I'd like to spend more time with you.
Nick,
Vicki, you're staying.
I'd like to spend more time like that with you in the next few weeks. I'm taking the promotion. I'm leaving a month.
Vicki.
Look. The promotion, it's just, it's a great opportunity. Well, I worked so hard for it. Well, the playwright, it won't be so terrible. You can all come visit me if you want. I just wish you all understand.
No, no, I don't understand, Nicholas. I don't.
Man.
How can you, Nicholas? We're here, Nicholas. Everything is here. How can you just leave your family like that? Why is everyone just so afraid? How can you? Aren't we worth staying for? How can you leave? How can you just leave? How can you just leave?
Man! Grant, you know I don't want to hurt you or Dan or...
What do you want me to say?
Stay. Please don't leave us. I can't say any of those things, Nick. I can't.
Everybody goes. I wish I could be more like my father. I wish I could stand on the shore and watch you sail away and know it's for the best. But I can't. I worked so hard my whole life, so my family, oh, I'm not good with saying things, Nick. I just don't want you to go. Noon. The grandmothers have made for us a beautiful meal. Mangiamo.
Nicky, your grandfather has something to tell
you.
Emma. He has something to tell you.
Oh, what is it, Gramps? It's something... I knew how dangerous Korea was, so I knew that. Still, all I did was stand and wait back. But inside I just kept wishing there was something, anything at all that I could say or do that would make him stay. There was nothing in me. Nothing. But now you're leaving me. Well, Nicky, let me ask you first. And tell me the truth, Nicky. Tell me the truth.
I will.
Okay. That day you had your attack, you were yelling and you said something about you needing to find out what you were about or something.
Gramps, I didn't mean what I was saying.
No, Nicholas. One thing I learned is that when people are upset, that's when they say exactly what they mean. Now tell me what you meant by that. Tell me.
I don't know, Gramps. Well, Gramps, I've lived here, and I've spent my whole life with you. It's been wonderful, so wonderful, and I'm so grateful. I just don't need it anymore, either. Well, there's an opportunity for me in Seattle. I just need to find out, you know, what it's all about. Grant, I'm so sorry if that sounds so selfish or ungrateful.
So Seattle, Grant. This is more than just some job. This is something you feel you have to do to make your life to be happy.
Yes. Absolutely.
And you know this as much as you know anything.
Yes. Yes. I'm so sorry.
Okay.
Graham, you said you had something to...
No.
But you said, Nicholas,
what I had to tell you. I will always be there with you.
With all the hassles and changing jobs in the city, I had very little time to spend with them this last week. That last Sunday came so quickly. I wish I knew what the formula was. How much do you owe those securities? How do you repay someone for their devotion?
Can it ever be enough?
Nicky, I hope you notice. In your honor, your grandfather put on the air conditioning today.
Yeah, I thought I could breathe.
It was a beautiful meal, wasn't it?
Stunning, man.
We made all your favorites. Gnocchi, veal parmesan, tiramisu, biscotti. You won't get a meal like that in Seattle.
I know. Man, I'm sorry.
For what?
Well, about Seattle.
Oh, Nicky, honey, you're not sorry.
No, Nan, I really am. I'm so sorry.
Maybe you feel bad for it, because you love it, but you're not sorry. And I think that's good. You have a wonderful life ahead of you, yes. Why waste time being sorry? If I was sorry for every sad thing that happened to me, I wouldn't be able to get out of bed anymore. One thing I know for sure, Nicky, you can't keep the people you love the most around forever. You can pray, you can scream, you can cry, can't keep them around forever. Funny, you know? I never really thought you looked much like your own Nicky. You were named for him, but I really couldn't see him in you. But I look at you now, and you look exactly like him. Just try to be happy, okay? There's nothing to be sorry about. So, Nicholas, did your grandfather tell you?
For what?
Selling
his car. No, he
tried driving to his mandolin lesson the other night. He's just the back end of it. Guess how? Pulling out the garage. Didn't even make it to the street. Thank God no one was killed. Nicky, before I forget, I got you another map card.
I wasn't on the campus to tell him about one. Graham, Danny just told me you're selling the car.
Yeah, I'm bored with driving.
Well, that's good. I would have been worried about you.
No, Nick. Don't worry about me.
Thank you.
wondering why.
Look, I hope you all know, I have to do this. I have to. I have to.
I caught my flight 6 hours later. I was in Seattle, my new home. And 2 days later, a 15-pound lasagna arrived for me in the mail. My new job, loved it. More challenging, more responsibility. And within a month, I started dating this account executive from my office, Teresa. Immediately, I knew she was pretty special. The next month, I returned home to attend the funeral of my grandpa Dunsky, who died from prostate cancer. They said it spread to his liver and kidney. My grandmother told me they knew about it before I left, but they didn't want to burden me with it. How could they have not have told me? Burden me? If any one of them would have, no question, I would have stayed.
I had to take care of him, he needed me to.
so much. But how many people can get to my age and say that? That there was someone who needed them that much. I can say that, thank you. I can't go. Not for years. Your grandfather built this house for me. How can I go? Thank you.
Okay. Not long after, I achieved what my grandparents thought to be the greatest accomplishment to man. I married Tangle Familiar. And now, as Teresa and I sit at home, awaiting the birth of our child, first child, my mind often wanders back to those, my grandparents, in those last few days. And I can't help but think that that's what it was like for me. But what is most clear to me is that my grandparents lived all of their lives and worked all of their lives trying to ensure that their family would be more educated and successful than they. But what they didn't perceive is that they would elevate me to a life more than they could comprehend. And as I look back, I too saw a vague reflection of myself. But still, they let me go. They got me to laugh, and to this day, I still get great scrutiny.
Everything came beautiful, didn't it?